You know, guys, there is a reason why Big Brother has a specific formula, and if there's anything we've learned coming out of the season, is that there should never be more than one eviction per week.
Don't change the channel.
Hey guys, it's Kevin. My review for Celebrity Big Brother Season 1, Episodes 8 through 9. And as you guys know, I've really been enjoying this season. We've had a lot more strategic gameplay. It's been a lot less about exposure and just trying to be on TV and just this one person having all the power week after week. It's really felt like Big Brother, and it is slowly coming to an end. I really can't believe it, but it actually is coming to a very quick end. It ends this Sunday. And of course, no season will be complete without at least one episode that pissed me off, because this was the first season in a while that didn't really piss me off. Big Brother 17 was the last one that didn't do it. Even that season, though, did have a dud, and this episode really was that dud for me. This week in general, I'm going to talk about everything that went down. There were things I did really like about this week, but the outcome kind of ruined most of it, and we're just going to get into it right now. So I think the first thing to talk about is, of course, Omarosa. She, of course, is the biggest player in this entire week because of the fact that she does, in fact, win the HOH. And I was really happy to see her because I genuinely thought that she was going to be the next one on the chopping block. I was really worried that she was going to be the one out. Everyone was really worried about her. They didn't believe a single thing she said. So I was really convinced that Omarosa was going to be the next one out, and it seemed like it would make sense too. I mean, her and Shannon, they kind of had this deal together. Shannon and they both kind of ruined it. Omarosa really had no one left in the house. It seemed like this was the time to possibly get her out. Luckily, though, she did in fact win the HOH, and I'm like, all right, let's go. Because if there's anything I can say about Omarosa is that she really knows how to create, really great drama and to really stir the pot. And that's something I was definitely really looking forward to seeing. I was very excited to see how that was actually going to go. And, for the most part, I thought she had a really great ground plan because, she, like I said, didn't really have anyone. Who else doesn't really have anyone? Well, that would be Mark, Meta, and James. Those three are kind of scrambling. As we know, James did have that deal with like Brandy and Ari and Marissa and Ross, but there was just no way he was ever going to take it. Brandy and James, it's just never gonna happen. Those two do not like each other at all. There's just no possible way they're ever going to work together, and he doesn't really trust most of them. He's known that they've wanted him out since day one, pretty much, so he does not really trust them at all. So I did think it was smart that Omarosa decided to create this sort of side alliance with the guys because they don't really have anyone, and I'm like, all right, this is really smart for her to do. She can go against the grain. She can find a way to make the more quieter ones and actually give them that power that they've desired. Again, I love seeing Ari and Brandy. I think they're definitely really great players. Marissa and Ross, I'm kind of getting tired of at this point, but I was happy to see her work with them. I thought this was a really smart move overall, and I thought right off the bat she had a very good idea in deciding to target Ross because she realized that Ross is really in alliance with everyone at this point. Ross is someone who has orchestrated a lot of the evictions. He was behind the Shannon eviction. He was behind, what went down with Keisha. He pretty much has everyone's, he's on everyone's good side at this point. Everyone, Ross is like the winner pick, really. Everyone really is rooting for him. So it would make sense to throw a wrench in that alliance completely and get Ross out. And I thought that was a very smart thing for her to do. Again, I was very impressed with Omarosa. I thought she had such a great ground plan. She really laid the work out for herself very well here, and she really could have pulled this off. There were legitimate ways that she could have gotten Ross out because there are so many things that, again, Ross has not done a very good job with. I've said this so many times before that Ross is just not good at keeping his word, and telling the truth and owning up to his actions. He just does not know how to do that. It's kind of the same weakness that Paul had, and I think that is ultimately what is going to kill his game. Now, I'm not going to be on the hate Ross train, because I genuinely do not think Ross is a bad person. You know, that's Big Brother 19. Big Brother 19, that was filled of highly unlikable, just very, just very unlikable, very distasteful people. This season is made up of really good people who are just kind of clueless about the game, and Ross happens to be one of them. And it's unfortunate, because Ross really does know Big Brother very well. I think the power's just kind of gone to his head a little bit, and he doesn't really know what he's doing at this point. And again, I thought she just laid out the work very well, and I was very excited to see where this was really going to go. But the other thing I really want to talk about is James and Mark, because these two decide to align together, and this was a very smart move on their part. I really did like what they were going to do here, because Mark in general, like I said, he, I think, has had the toughest road out of everyone. He has just struggled to make any sort of connection. He can't seem to solidify anything. James is really scrambling at this point, so he decides that he is going to work with Mark. However, I think they made a really bad decision in deciding to ally with Marissa, because there was just no way she was ever going to actually take that deal, which was dumb, honestly, on her part. I think at this point, when you're in the game, which they know they have 1 week left, so at this point it's about, you know, who is going to get me to the end. Marissa is someone to take to the end because of the fact that she, again, is in this huge alliance. Ross could get out at any point. And if Ross gets out, Marissa's going to be all alone. So this was a very smart move to possibly ally with Marissa. The problem is Marissa is taking things so personally that she does not want to take a deal with them. And, you know, she doesn't even say no. She says, I'll think about it, which, if someone says, I'll think about it, that is basically the definition of no, I never want to work with you, don't even ask me about it, you already know the answer. So, I don't know why James and Mark didn't understand that, why they didn't just think, oh, this isn't going to work out at all, we got to go back to Omarosa and Meta. But that alliance just completely fell through the cracks, and this is where we get to the frustrating part of the season. Again, I'm genuinely enjoying the season, but the thing that constantly continues to kind of annoy me is the fact that no one can solidify any kind of alliance. Anything that is, you know, made up 1 week is completely destroyed the next. It does not seem like there's any sort of consistency when it comes to alliances, and it's disappointing because I think Omarosa, Mark, Meta, and James, that is a very surprising alliance that I think could work together very well. It's kind of like an exterminator sort of thing. Now, again, I'm not a fan of Big Brother 15. I think that was, again, very similar to Big Brother 19. It was filled with very unlikable people. But that Exterminator Alliance, they did a really great job in taking themselves to the end and getting out the bigger targets and, you know, finding a way so the more quieter ones could actually have a chance in the finale. And I think they could have done something similar with this alliance because, again, Mark and Meta were never anyone's target. Meta's wanted to be out since day one. Mark has never made any sort of connection whatsoever. And James is someone who is kind of everyone's kind of skeptical about. There's some people that want to work with him, some that don't. So Omarosa allying with those three would have been such a great decision for her game. And if she would have stuck to it, I would have said Omarosa's going to get to the end, definitely. And she's going to win this entire thing. I think it would have been such a smart move on her part. And the fact that it just did not pan out really does piss me off overall. I think this would have been the perfect move for her. And like I said, it just didn't really work out for her at all. Now I want to get to the stuff that really did piss me off, though, because let's talk about Brandy. As you guys know, I have been very high on Brandy this entire season. I think she has done an incredible job at completely subverting our expectations. She's actually played a very solid game with Ari. Those two have worked very well together in getting into either Ross or Marissa's ear or whoever is HOH and getting them paranoid, getting the target that they want out every single week. I think they did a great job with that. But let's talk about this Hinky vote, because that's nothing new in Big Brother. This has always been a staple of Big Brother. You know, there's always one person who wants to go against the grain, and this time it was Brandy. Now, I thought this was just a random thing. I thought this was just one of those things where she gave a hinky vote to, you know, kind of increase paranoia within the house guests, and that's what was going on. But that's not really what this was. It was more of a sympathy vote. She saw how hurt Shannon was. She didn't want Shannon to leave on a unanimous vote, so she decided to keep her in. And I thought this was a good thing to do. You know, it makes sense. You know, Shannon, obviously, Her entire game, like I said, was pretty much squandered. And I didn't say this in the last video, but I genuinely think Shannon could have done really well. If this season was longer, we could have had the 3 to 4 week lull where Shannon tries to secure a deal and maybe she does get to work with James. Maybe she does work in that alliance with Omarosa, Mark, Meta, and James. You know, they could have easily solidified something. But again, because it is an expedited season, there isn't time to do that. So I think that's really a big thing with Shannon. I think, again, you know, we shouldn't discount her as a player. I think what we should discount is the fact this season is just too short and there was not time for her to really solidify any kind of deal there. So I think that really is what happened with Shannon. That's a whole separate topic. What Brandy did, the point is not really that big of a deal. And Brandy says this, and I very much agree. It really would not have changed anything. It was basically unanimous minus her one vote. What would her one vote have done besides just be completely unanimous? I mean, no one wants to hear when you're leaving the house by a unanimous vote. Nobody wants to hear that because then you think, oh, everyone hates me. You know, I'm hated by America. You start getting all these things in your head and no one really wants to hear that. And I don't really see why it was such a huge problem that Brandy went against them. But what I was even more disappointed by was Ari, because Ari was Brandy's closest ally. These two had a very good deal together. And don't get me wrong, I do still think Ari's playing a good game. But the fact that she would really get mad at Brandy and not try to defend her just didn't really make a lot of sense to me. I mean, that is the person that has been pushing for you to win this game and has done everything in her power so you can win the game. So what I thought at first was going on is that Ari and Brandy had some sort of plan where they were going to try to create a fake fight, you know, something a la Big Brother 11, you know, where that whole lie that I believe it was like Natalie and Kevin, they had this fight and that kind of changed the game. I thought that was what was going on here, that they would create some sort of fake fight, make people think that they weren't working together again. And, you know, similar to also what Dan did in Big Brother 14 with Danielle, I thought that's kind of what was going on here. But that's not really what happened. Ari was genuinely upset. She was ready to just take Brandy out of the alliance altogether. And Brandy was willing to, you know, they were willing to apologize to her, but Brandy's not willing to go back there. And I completely understand that. I mean, they were not at all understanding. They were like, how could you do this? Why would you do this to us? Why have you betrayed our trust? I mean, they were just way too hard on her about it. It really was not that big of a deal. It would be different, you know, it would be different if it was a situation where there was a chance Shannon could stay and Brandy was one of the deciding votes that actually kept her in the house. But Shannon's no longer there and it was an almost unanimous vote. So I don't really see what the problem is here. I don't really see why this is such a big deal. And honestly, I'm really hoping Brandy wins HOH next, because I really want to see herself get out of this. I don't want this to be the thing that actually takes Brandy out of this game. I think it's a really dumb move if that's why they want to get her out of here. You know, I understand that they think she's being shady, but this should not be the thing that gets her out of the game. It's really dumb overall. I think these house guests really need to rethink it, because Brandy, again, that is someone to keep around. That is someone who doesn't want to win. She wants Ari to win. That's been her game plan since the beginning. She's not playing to win. She's playing so Ari can win. And you know, if she wins, that'd be great. I think, you know, her and Ari are both just as deserving of that, but of that title. But Brandy in general, I really did feel bad for her throughout all this. There was no reason for them to be so hard on her, and I'm really hoping, like I said, she's able to pull herself out of this in the next 6 days, but we'll have to see. But with all that said, let's get into this eviction, because holy shit, did this go down fast. I mean, there were so many options that could happen here. You know, we could have had Omarosa, she could have gotten Ross out, and it would have been incredible. No one would have seen it coming. Ross does know that he's a target, but the fact that Ross would have gotten out, I think it would have been fine. It would have definitely, like I said, given Omarosa that win. She would have made herself a target, but I think knowing how Omarosa is and how backstabbing she she can, you know, how she's able to get into people's heads and plant all these different seeds and kind of blame what happened on other people. I think she's done a very good job in getting that target off her back and being one of those people who's like, why is she still here? I think Omarosa's done an incredible job with that. And if she would have gotten Ross out, like I said, I would have said just give her the win right then and there, because that would have been incredible. I would have loved to see that happen. But of course, that's not what happened, because we had to have this stupid veto in play, which, let me just say, what was the point of this, honestly? What was the point of this twist? I've said it before and I'll say it again. Twists do not help Big Brother. If anything, they collude with the formula, and that's something I really do not like about Big Brother, is that they feel the need to add all these twists in there, and usually I understand it. You know, what I do sort of understand is, you know, the whole thing where, oh, the season's so long, we gotta keep this twist in here to make things more interesting. But again, the season is ending in 6 days, so I don't see the reason to even add this twist in here. And, you know, more importantly, it did nothing for the game in general. There was no reason to put this in here. Ross does, of course, win POV, but it's a special POV, and it's the one I really did not want. There were some that I genuinely wanted. Like, if they were to bring the Diamond Power Veil back, that would have been really cool. It would have been nostalgic, and would have felt like, okay, this is classic Big Brother again. I remember when they used to do that every single season, and, well, not every season, but they used to do it a lot more, and now it's just kind of something that's been put on the back burner, and it would have been cool to see that reintroduced into the game. That's the one that I voted for. That's the one I thought that was gonna win. Then there was, like, the Spotlight one, where basically they had to use it. Like, they didn't have a choice. They had to use the veto, and then they get to name a replacement nominee. But, of course, the VIP is the one that wins, and this one is the most confusing, and honestly, I still don't fully understand it. That's how confusing it really is, because sure, Ross does have the veto, he's able to take himself down, but once Omarosa names a second nominee, he can then do something to take down one of the nominations, basically has a second veto as well. What didn't make sense to me is, does this mean he's able to take down both of the nominees? Like, he can take down the renom and the person that, and the pawn that was still there? Or can he actually, you know, take down, or can he just take down the pawn? I did not understand the way that worked. But before we get to the rest of how this eviction did pan out, let me just say, I have no idea how Ross actually won this veto, because the veto in general was very suspenseful. I thought they did a good job of really keeping us on the edge of our seat, but it really seemed like Omarosa was about to win. You know, she ran in first. It seemed like Julie was about to say Omarosa, but no, Ross ended up winning, and I don't totally understand why. I don't know if there's something we didn't see, but from what I saw, it looked like Omarosa was gonna be the winner, and if that was the case, I'm pretty sure she would have kept the nominations the same, maybe taken Brandy off, put Marissa up. She might have done that. But other than that, I pretty much thought she was going to just keep it the same, and I don't really know why Ross won POV, but we'll get into what happens in a little bit. Luckily, he doesn't end up using it, but this is when things just get really lame, because again, I really thought, the second that Ross came down, I'm like, alright, Omarosa's, she's going to do something big here, she's going to put up Marissa, and this could have worked out, too. I mean, you know, a lot of people are saying, oh, well, Ross could have just used it. Well, not entirely, because she could have just put up Ari. Ross could have taken Ari down. Then she could have put Marissa up. It's still a lot of gameplay in one night, but I just thought Omarosa was a lot smarter than this. I thought she really could have done something big here. But no, they take the safest way out, and what do they decide to do? They decide that even though he has 6 days left, we're going to finally get Meta out. He's been so adamant about leaving. Let's just get him out now. And this was really annoying, to be honest with you. I did not understand why they got Meta out here. Look, I get it that he has been, you know, so set on leaving, but this is exactly the reason why you want to keep Meta around, because of the fact that he is going to, you know, he is so set on not playing the game. is someone who has deliberately done whatever he can to stay out of the conversation. He doesn't understand this game. He doesn't understand what a veto is. He didn't even understand, you know, some of the HOHs they've played. He doesn't understand how this stuff works. So that is exactly the reason why you keep Meta around. Why? He is the perfect person to beat. There is no one in the jury who can say, oh, Meta did this. There is no move that Meta made. He didn't play the game at all. And because of that, this is exactly the reason why you want to keep Meta around. So I really did not see the need for this at all. It was really dumb. And it just ends what could have been a really eventful night on a very low note and definitely severely pissed me off here. But it's not all bad. I will definitely say that there were some things I did enjoy about this episode. First of all, everything going on with Brandy, the way that she is trying to take the target off herself, you know, the way that she is now trying to make James and Mark a target, that could have been really great. I really wanted to see something happen there. I wanted to see maybe a Mark or a James go up and Brandy try to get into their heads. I mean, that would have been awesome to see, but again, we just didn't really get anything of it. It just didn't really pan out at all. But the biggest thing heading into next week is I want to see Brandy get herself out of this, because again, there is no reason why they should be this pissed at her. It's not like Shannon had a chance of staying. It's not like she was one of the reasons why Shannon is still there. Shannon is gone. I don't know why they won't just let this go. It's a really dumb, petty thing, and I think it attributes to the fact that this is a much more civilized, mellow season. There hasn't been as many confrontations. I mean, sure, there has been, but they've been a lot more adult and mature about it than we've seen in other Big Brother seasons. You know, there's no mob mentality this season. There's no, let's gather around this person and just call them out on personal things. That's not what's going on this season. So I think because that the house guests are a little bit more sensitive than they would be in a normal season, that's why Marissa's taking everything so personally. So yeah, I mean, is it annoying? Yes, I will definitely agree that it is very annoying. I don't like seeing Marissa so pissed at Brandy. I don't like seeing Ari so, I don't like seeing Ross so pissed at her. It just isn't necessary. Brandy is someone to keep around. I mean, I don't get the reason for wanting to get her out. And like I said, I really am hoping Brandy can get herself out of this really quick. The thing that worries me is that it is a double eviction on Friday, and there just might not be a lot of time. And because of that, this might be the time to get Brandy out. They might think, hey, it's a double eviction. You know, we don't have a lot of time. Let's just do what we can and get Brandy out. We have legit reasons to get her out. And we'll have to see the way that really does play out. Because again, I do want to see Brandy there for a while. As far as Omarosa goes, I'm really disappointed. I genuinely am very disappointed with her, because I really thought Omarosa was smarter than this. I really thought Omarosa was someone who wants to make a big move, who wants to do something manipulative. And again, these Monday evictions really need to go, honestly. There's a reason why there's only been one eviction usually in the week. There's not usually two. And to me, it just seems like the house guests, the Monday eviction is just filler. Like, the Monday eviction is just kind of there. We're going to reserve all the real gameplay for the Thursday nights and for the Friday nights, and it's just not a good look. It's really not a good look at all, and if they do plan on bringing the show back, which I could very well see them doing, this season has been pretty successful overall, they really need to rethink about this whole Monday eviction, because we've had it with Keisha, now we've had it with Meta. They've both been legitimate quits. They have not been something where it's like, oh, we have no one else to get out, let's just get out Meta. These have been quits, and it's ridiculous. It's very pathetic, and again, I understand the house guests thought they were doing something good, but Meta literally had 6 days left. Like, you couldn't just have kept him hanging around for 6 more days and drag him to the end again. That would have been what you should have done. And honestly, if, like, Omarosa or Brandy or Ari would have won that final HOH in the finale night, and Meta was still there, they should have taken Meta. They really should have. But again, they're just not really thinking about that, and that really is what did annoy me here. So yes, I am definitely very pissed off that they took the safe way out and got Meta, and just got Meta to leave. It was really dumb overall. I think there were legitimate reasons to keep him around. What I'm hoping is that Omarosa decides to keep this alliance with James and Mark. It's a good idea for her. You know, she doesn't really have anyone, and James and Mark, you know, they they seem to have some sort of tight bond here, and I'm hoping finally that we can have some sort of consistency, because again, these alliances, they just can't keep them consistent, and I'm hoping that this is the first one that actually does successfully survive. I'm also hoping that Ahri and Brandi do make amends here. I don't want to see this ruin their alliance. I think they work very well together, and I don't want to see this ruin it. I really don't want to see that happen. I do still see Ahri as the winner pick, and I'll tell you why. On the live feed, they've literally said that they would be okay losing to Ahri. So I do still see her as the winner pick. I could very well see her winning this game. I could also see Mark because he hasn't really done much of anything, and he's done what he can to get the blood off of his hands. And maybe he could really stir up some drama in the next 6 days, but we'll just have to see the way that really does play out. There's not really a lot of time left, and I'm definitely interested in seeing what's going to happen in these next 6 days. I'm hoping the house guests don't just quit. I'm hoping they continue. What's been so great about this season is the manipulation, is the fact that these house guests do in fact want to play, and I hope that keeps up here. I hope they're not just like, you know what, we got 6 days left, let's just go through the motions and get out players that don't really do anything, and that'll take us to the end. I'm hoping that's not really what happens, or I'm hoping it's a really successful send-off. We'll just have to see the way that really does play out in the double eviction. Also, guys, from here on out, I will be reviewing every episode individually, solely because the fact that Friday is a double eviction, there's going to be a lot to cover, and I don't want the video to be like 40 minutes long, so I will review Wednesday episode on Wednesday, and you know, Fridays on you know, Saturday, so definitely look forward to that. But that's in my review. Hope guys will see you guys in my next video. Let me know what you guys thought of this episode overall. Like I said, I was legitimately enjoying the season, but this really did piss me off overall. This was just a really, really dumb move to make, and I think they really could have done something a lot better here. But I will see you guys in my next video, and I will see you guys for that. Okay, bye.